وعليكم السلام ورحمة
الله وبركاته. أهلاً وسهلاً ومرحباً بكم. While we are waiting for Molana to arrive, both the Molanas, we'll start off with Durood Sharif and then a few nasheeds, inshallah.
Inshallah.
And by then, inshallah, they will be here.
Allahumma
salli ala Muhammad. Ya Rabbi salli alayhi wa sallim. اللهم صل على محمد يا ربي صل عليه وسلم في حب سيدنا محمد نور لبدر الهدى متمم قلبي يحن إلى محمد ما زال بوجده متيم اللهم صل على محمد يا ربي صل عليه وسلم اللهم صل على محمد يا ربي صل عليه وسلم ما لي حبيب سوى محمد خير الرسول النبي المكرم شوق المحب إلى محمد أفناه ثم به تغيم اللهم صل على محمد يا رب صل عليه وسلم اللهم صل على محمد يا رب صل عليه وسلم في الحشر شافعنا محمد منجي الخلائق من جهنم ميلاد سيدنا محمد أم القراب بلد معظم اللهم صل على محمد يا رب صل عليه وسلم اللهم صل على محمد يا رب صل عليه وسلم أحيا الدجى زمنا محمد مولاه سلمه وكلم أدعوك أحمد يا محمد يا سيد الرسل المقدم اللهم صل على محمد يا رب صل عليه وسلم اللهم صل على محمد يا رب صل عليه وسلم اللهم صل على محمد يا رب صل عليه وسلم اللهم صل على محمد يا رب صل عليه وسلم صلي على نبينا صلي على محمد الله ما لنا مولا سوى الله كل ما ناديت ياه قال يا عبدي أنا الله 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 ما لنا الله وعفانا ارسل من الله يا له شار عظيم وشريف كرم الله يا مولى الله 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 ما لنا مولى سوى الله كلما ناديت ياه قال يا أبري أنا الله فيه جمع قد فرحنا وبنيل الغد فزنا يا رسول الله تبنا وعلينا أنما الله يا مولى الله 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 ما لنا مولى سوى الله كلما ناديت ياه قال يا عبدي أنا الله ظهر دين المؤيد بظهور الحادي أحمد يا هنان النبي محمد ذلك الفضل من الله يا مولى الله 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 ما لنا مولى سوى الله كلما ناديت ياه قال يا أبري أنا الله ثاني عشر في الربيع كان ميلاد شفيع سويب القدر الرفيع من له قد أيد الله يا مولى الله 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 ما لنا مولى سوى الله كلما ناديت ياه نكس العاصمة سنام جحرا وبه إيوان كسرى بات متصديا من الله يا مولى الله 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 ما لنا مولى سوى الله كلما ناديت ياه قال يا أبري أنا الله يوم ميلاد الثحام خاتم الرسل المرسل الكرام زخرفت دار السلام ما أتى النصر من الله يا مولا الله 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 ما لنا مولا سوى الله كلما ناديت ياه قال يا أبني أنا أنت تعلم كيف حالي وبما قد حل قلبي من حموم واشتغالي يا مولا الله 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 ما لنا مولا سوى الله كلما قال يا أبري أنا الله يا إله العالمين يا مجيب السائلين يا قدوس يا سلام يا مليك الملكين يا مولا الله 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 ما لنا مولا سوى الله كلما ناديت ياه قال يا أبري أنا الله ظهر دين المؤيد بظهور الحادي أحمد يا هنانا بمحمد ذلك الفضل من الله يا مولا الله 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 ما لنا مولا سوى الله كلما
الحمد لله رب العالمين ولا عاقبة للمتقين والصلاة والسلام على
أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وبعد فقد قال الله سبحانه وتعالى في القرآن المجيد والفرقان الحميد بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم لقد من الله على المؤمنين إذ بعث فيهم رسولا صدق الله العظيم وقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أن أكرم الأولين والآخرين ولا فخر أو كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي
صلى الله عليه وسلم
يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما
الله
صل على سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا محمد وأصحابه وبارك وسلم عليه سلك الله مولانا العظيم وسلك رسوله النبي الكريم ونحن على ذلك من الشاهدين والشاكرين والحمد لله رب العالمين. Respected Mufti and my teacher Salim Khalifa Fadl Sheikh Isa الحاضرين السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. Alhamdulillah, once again, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have chosen us to be present here to celebrate and commemorate the birth, the life, the existence, the characteristics of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And alhamdulillah, we have been fortunate that we have been invited to this type of mahafil from the first day of Rabbi al-Awwal up till now.
Alhamdulillah, subhanallah.
And we have, alhamdulillah, learned a lot of the life of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Not only his life, his character, the way he behaved sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with people, how he spoke to people, how he dealt with different types of problems, so forth and so on, alhamdulillah. Some of the history we have learned. And however, Mr. Zalebi. So we have learned all of these things, alhamdulillah, and today I apologize on behalf of Maulana Sikandar. He did call me and tell me that he is on his way from somewhere, Johannesburg. So he'll be late. And we are very fortunate that Mufti Salim is here. He don't like this title, but he did complete his Mufti course. And when I got to the Darul Uloom, he was already there. My first letter that was ever written by myself and corrected by him.
Subhanallah.
We are grateful for our teachers, no matter what little they have given to us at that point in time. And the hadith he wrote on that paper, because I spoke about Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, so I didn't know this. He wrote it, لَوْلَاكَ لَمَا خَلَقَتُ الْأَفْلَاكَ, in his handwriting, because I couldn't write Arabic at that point in time. It looked like, you know, somebody like a doctor. So he wrote it for me nicely. I didn't know it. He wrote it. And that is how I learned this hadith from him. Alhamdulillah, preserve him. And we will call upon him today to address us, inshallah. After him, will be Khalifa Fadil, the Khalifa of Sheikh Mazin, Fathullah Khalifa Husseini. He will inspire us with some of the things he told me this whole week. It is very inspirational, so we will take it from there, inshallah. As we have this custom in welcoming our suyukh, so we will do just that, inshallah. Nari takbir.
Allahu Akbar.
I hear some, like, some and some not, so let us try it again. I want to see that light must move a little bit. Nari takbir.
Allahu Akbar.
Nari risalat.
Ya Rasulallah.
Alam ahli sunnah.
Zidnallah.
The only time I respect, I remember Arafat is when he got married. So since he's from Cape Town, he didn't know what is the meaning of Appa. And I used to call his wife Appa, so, and she remembers me with that as well. But though as it may, first and foremost, let me just thank my brother Feroz here. I just felt the joy when I was coming and I realized his voice. Nahsabu ala khair is one of the people that I look forward to, because I had some good experiences with him, and I know he doesn't like me to mention much of that. But though is it, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep on increase the sweetness in your voice. When I came here, I was actually coming for Niyaz, because they say that the Niyaz that is connected to the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it is having so much barakah. And when Imam Shafi visited Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal, the daughter of Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal was surprised with the way Imam Shafi was eating. She went to her father and she asked that, oh my father, this is Imam Shafi that everyone is talking about. How come he's eating so much food? And Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal said to his daughter, go and ask him why he's eating so much food. So when she went and she asked Imam Shafi said that in the food of Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal, there is so much dawa, there is so much cure, there is so much rahmah. That is why he was eating that food. Why this is the tabarruk of the awliya Allah. But though as it may, when I come to the house of Haji Fadil, the only thing that I have to speak about is salawat upon the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. I was looking at something here. It is written that adimi salata ala al-habibi Muhammadin faqulbuluha khatman biduni taraddudin fa'inna a'maluna bayna al-qubuli wa raddiha illa salata ala nabiyyi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That always recite salutations upon the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Why? Because this is the only amal that is totally accepted. The scholars have said that this is the only action that a person can do with pride. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answers that salawat upon this person. This is the only action that if a person does, no matter what state he is in, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answers the call or the dua of this person. So this shair is saying that if you are going to do that action, it is such an action that is never rejected in the court of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All our actions are between acceptance and rejection, except salawat upon the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And just looking at the salawat upon the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah Rabbul Izzah says that inna Allah wa malaikatahu. Whenever you look at the Holy Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he uses the harfu atfu, which is waw, it is always inna Allah wa rasulahu. Inna alladhina yushaqiqu Allah wa rasulahu. This is the only person and personality, the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that we see this harfu atfu being used. Allah and His Rasul, Allah and His Rasul. The only place in the Holy Quran where it is used without the Holy Prophet, it is inna Allah wa malaikatahu. What do they do? Yusalluna ala al-Nabi. Everything is about the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And when you are to look at the Holy Quran, there is no way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala puts ya ayyuhal ladina amanu in the middle of a sentence. Wherever ya ayyuhal ladina amanu is being recited, it's either in the beginning of a surah or in the beginning of an ayah. But it is only this verse whereby Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that inna Allah wa malaikatahu yusalluna ala nabi ya ayyuhal ladina amanu. And when Allah says ya ayyuhal ladina amanu, the scholars have told us that this shows intense love that Allah has for the believers. Ya ayyuhal ladina amanu sallu alayhi wa sallimu taslima. Salawat upon the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If you see yourself reciting salawat upon the Holy Prophet, know that you are amongst those people who are fortunate. Why am I saying this? Because the Holy Prophet says that man salla alayya wahida, whosoever will send one salawat upon me, sallallahu biha ashara, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send 10 salawat upon this person. And one salawat from Allah to you is better than the dunya and whatever is in it. So Allah, the scholars have said, Hasha lillah, it is not befitting to Allah to send that salawat to that person who is unfortunate. So whenever you see yourself getting the tawfiq to recite salawat upon the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, know that you are amongst those people who are fortunate. And Allah will never grant the capability to do so to that person who is unfortunate. It is the Nabi of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that has so much great status in the court of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is why we as human beings, we can't send salawat upon the Holy Prophet. We ask Allah to send salawat upon the Holy Prophet. Why? Because he knows the maqam of the Habib. The scholars have said in regards to the hadith whereby there is an angel that is at the Hujra Sharif that sends salawat to the Holy Prophet from anyone who sends salawat. We asked our teachers that why should there be an angel that acts and get that salawat to the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Mind you, there are those people who send salawat upon the Holy Prophet, and the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam answers them directly. But here there is an angel also which delivers salutations to the Holy Prophet. The scholars have told us that this is the only type of ibadah that has a secretary, household. There are those who come and they will say, Allahumma salli ala Muhammad. And there are those who make a fatha into a kasra into a dhamma. This angel's duty is to beautify your salawat, so that your salawat can be listened to by sam'u sharif, by honorable ears. So the angel will write that Arafat came here and he said, Allahumma salli ala Muhammad. It will write that Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina wa Habibina wa Shafi'ina wa Mawlana Muhammad. So that Allah can shower his message. This Nabi of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala holds such a great status in the life of a believer. Once Hazrat Ka'bi comes to the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, O Nabi of Allah, how much salawat should I read upon you? Can I try that one third of my day, I'll read salawat upon you? The Holy Prophet said, it's fine, but if you can increase, it will be better. He said, what if I make half of my day to be salawat upon you? The Holy Prophet said, it's okay, but if you can increase, then it will be better. Until he said, O Nabi of Allah, what if I make all my life to be salawat upon you? The scholars have said that if people know or knew what is in salawat, they would spend the whole day reciting salawat upon the Holy Prophet and waiting for faraid salat. That is the greatness. When the Holy Prophet said that if you do so, if you spend your whole life reading salawat upon me, then all your sadness, all your trials and tribulations will come to an end and Allah will forgive you. How many of us are going through so much trials and tribulations and we don't recite salawat upon the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? This very Ka'bah, if you are to look at another hadith, Mawlana Arafat, you will see that it is that very Nabi, that Sahabi of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that once at night the Holy Prophet, because of reading salawat, the Holy Prophet comes to his door late at night. If you read this salawat upon the Holy Prophet, inshallah you have his ru'ya in your dream or in your lifestyle. The Holy Prophet comes to his house at night. He knocks at the door. He said, Khair ya Rasulullah. Who is at the door? He said, the Holy Prophet. He said, Khair ya Rasulullah, is everything okay? The Sahabi, the Holy Prophet says, O Ka'b, open the door. He opens the door. He said, O Nabi of Allah, this time of the day. He said to him, Inna Allah qad arsalani ilay. That, O Ka'b, verily Allah has sent me to you.
Subhanallah.
Hazrat Ka'b said that this day was the best day in my life. It was better than this dunya and whatever was in it. He said, O Nabi of Allah, Allah mentioned me by name. The Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, O Ka'b, indeed Allah mentioned you by name. When he hears this, he said, O Nabi of Allah, what is it that you came from? The Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, you have to recite the Holy Quran. Then Hazrat Ka'b said that, O Nabi of Allah, how can I recite it to you when it was revealed to you? The Holy Prophet told Ka'b that, O Ka'b, Allah wants to hear it from you. It was all the salutations, the connection that he had with the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I can speak all night in regards to salawat, but let me mention this. Once Imam Al-Ghazali, who is Hujjatul Islam, he always used to have a dars with his students. And whenever he had a dars, he used to have a Q&A after the dars, like most of our shuyukhs do. So one day he had a Q&A and one person raised his hand. He said, O Imam Al-Ghazali, what is the meaning of the ayah, Kulla yawmin huwa fi sha'an? This ayah translates as, every day Allah is engaging in something. Imam Al-Ghazali said that, O my brother, I haven't come across the meaning of it. I will go and do some research. He comes back the following day, he had a dars. The same person raises his hands. they asked the same question. The following day, until Imam Al-Ghazali was uncomfortable. It was a Thursday night, he goes home, he recites salawat upon the Holy Prophet until he goes to sleep. He sees the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in his dream. You know, seeing the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in our dreams, it's a sign of a person who yearns to meet the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Imagine if the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would send a message to us and say he's coming to visit us next week. What are we going to change in our lives? But let me tell you, if there is anything that you are thinking of changing in your life, you better do so. Because very soon, we'll be blessed with the ruya of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in our graves. We'll be blessed with the ruya of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on the day of judgment. Imam Al-Ghazali sees the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You know, just before I go forward, before I forget this narration, when Imam Jalaluddin Suyuti saw the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he stopped going to the mosque. There was nothing that made sense after he grasped the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He stopped going for Jummah. He used to pray Zuhr. Because after seeing his beloved, nothing made sense. He just wanted to be in the company. He yearned to be in the company of the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So Imam Al-Ghazali sees the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And when he sees the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says to him, "Oh Al-Ghazali, there is a person who is always coming to ask you questions. The question he is asking you is that, what is the meaning of kulla yawmin huwa fi sha'an? That Allah is always engaging in something. When you meet this person tomorrow, tell him that the meaning of that is that Allah is raising the status of other people and he is lowering the status of other people." Imam Al-Ghazali got so excited that the following morning he ran to the class. Before he could teach that day, he wanted to fulfill this answer. He says, "Where is the questionnaire?" The Q&A now started before the lesson because of so much excitement. He said, the questionnaire said, "I'm here, my brother. Do you have an answer for me?" Imam Al-Ghazali tells him that the meaning of the ayah you were asking me, I understand it now. It means that Allah is raising the status of other people and lowering the status of other people. This man said to Imam Al-Ghazali, "You need to make more salawat upon the one who gave you the answer." You need to make more salawat upon the person who gave you the answer. Sometimes we have awliya Allah in our midst and we don't understand it. Once Hazrat Jibril asked Allah that, "Ya Allah, who is your best servant?" Allah says, "Go to Baghdad, there is a person who is this, my servant is there." He comes to the mosque, he sees everyone is praying. As everyone is praying, there was one brother who was just sitting at the corner. And everyone is doing the... Hazrat Jibril is looking for the nicest khushu, the one who is reading the nice Quran and everything. He goes to this brother, he says, "My brother, everyone is praying here. Why are you sitting?" He said, "My brother, you are here in the mosque. You do what you do, and I do what I do." Hazrat Jibril got angry. He's looking for the wali of Allah. There was back and forth clash there between Hazrat Jibreel and this man. This man said, "My brother, do you want me to tell all these people that are here that Jibreel is with us today?" Allah. We will never know them. They are hidden, some of them. So this is salawat upon the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And if a person is going to devote himself to the salawat of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you are going to see changes in your life. They say, the scholars have told us that if you look even in Salatul Janaza, there is salawat upon the Holy Prophet. Because it's an amal that Allah will never reject. And it is not befitting of Allah to reject, to accept a portion of ibadah and reject the rest. So when we pray Salatul Janaza, we must always know that this Salatul Janaza is accepted. And Allah is going to deal with us according to how we think of Him. The problem with our times is we think of Allah according to who we think he is, not how he described himself to be. If he says he's Ghafur Rahim, then he is Ghafur Rahim. Never ever think or say to yourself, will Allah ever forgive you? They say thinking like that, it's worse than the sin that you have committed. Hazrat Ali went on to say that whosoever thinks that Allah won't forgive him, and he quotes the ayah, La taqnatu min rahmatillah, do not lose hope in the mercy of Allah. Whosoever thinks like that, he has committed kufr. He's out of the fold of Islam. Why? Because he is Ghafur Rahim. The Sahaba Ikram, just to conclude on this milad, because I will go off, they had so much love for the Holy Prophet. Such love, I think our brothers are here. The first thing that I learned in Urdu was that wojo na te to kuchi na ta, wojo na ho to kuchi na ho. Jis dil mein Muhammad ki muhabbat nahi hoti, us par kabhi Allah ki rahmat nahi. Love is when Hazrat Abu Bakr was seen crying. They asked him that, Ya Abu Bakr, ma yubki? Oh Abu Bakr, why are you crying? He said, Ra'aytu Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam yabki fa bakayt. I saw the Holy Prophet crying, so I also started crying. Love is when the Holy Prophet and Hazrat Abu Bakr, both of them were thirsty. And Hazrat Abu Bakr said, Wannabi of Allah, I'm not thirsty. You can have this glass of water. There was only one glass of water. And he tells us in Sahih Muslim that فَشَرِبَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ حَتَّى رُمِيتْ, that the Holy Prophet drank the water until I quenched my thirst. That's how much the Sahaba Ikram used to love the Holy Prophet. You know, there is two aspects. There is ishq, the love of the Holy Prophet that comes from a human being that is deep inside this person. And there is itba to follow. And we need to distinguish between the two. Because following does not show that you really love. I'll tell you an example. I was looking at one sheikh, mashallah, good sunnah, everything, 100%. I looked at him speaking about following the sunnah of the Holy Prophet on YouTube. Then the next topic, you know, YouTube always comes with the next topic. The next topic was that the parents of the Holy Prophet are in Jahannam. Then what type of love is that? The love that I'm going to share to you today is ishq. I told one brother that I was in Medina. He started crying. I'm like, why are you even crying? But he was longing to be, he envied me. He longed to be in the company of the Holy Prophet. One hadith and another hadith will follow him, just to conclude. There was a sahabi of the Holy Prophet. He used to drink beer. It's haram. And every time when he would come to the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they used to give him had. Had is punishment. So they would beat him for drinking beer. He would come the other day, drunk, and sometimes he would come when he's normal, sometimes. But every time he used to get had. Once one sahabi said that, how can you keep on coming here, you're drinking beer? When the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam heard this, he got angry. His rahmatan lil alamin. He said, do not help shaitan over your brother. That part we understand it. But he went on to say that, فَإِنَّهُ يُحِبُّ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولُهُ. But this very person, the Holy Prophet is saying that, do not help your brother over shaitan. The very person, this brother, the Holy Prophet says that he loves Allah and his Rasul. Now we always judge according to how we see people. The person is doing wrong. It means he doesn't love Allah and his Rasul. No, this hadith contradicts everything. So the scholars had to sit and just study this part, which says that, فَإِنَّهُ يُحِبُّ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولُهُ. They came to the conclusion that this person used to come in the court of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he would see people. You remember when Sheikh was here? People will be coming. There will be coming. Problems. Everything. he would see that the Holy, he would look at the Holy Prophet, and he would see that the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is taking so much stress of people. You know, spiritual people, we don't understand them, but they take a lot. And he would see this fatigue, this stress of the Holy Prophet. He would make a small joke, and the Holy Prophet would smile. The Holy Prophet would smile. When the Holy Prophet would smile for this guy's joke, then for this man, it meant the dunya and whatever is in it. It was everything to him. Just to see the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam smiling, it meant everything to him. And when we speak about following the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it seems sometimes we have priorities to our sunnah. This hadith which says that man ahabba sunnati faqad ahabbani wa man ahabbani kana ma'i fil jannah, it's a hadith that needs to be revised. Why? Because this hadith is in regards to Hazrat Anas bin Malik. Hazrat Anas bin Malik was that sahabi that the mother made qurban. She said, O Nabi of Allah, there is my son Malik, he will save you. And it is this very same Malik that would say that ma samamtu rihan atyaba min rihi rasulillah wa ma masastu dibajan aliyana min yadi rasulillah. He used to say that I have never smelled any fragrance like the fragrance that would come out of the body mubarak of the Holy Prophet, and I have never touched any hand that was soft like the hand of the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He says that once I came to the court of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, I looked at the moon, full moon, and I looked at the face of the Holy Prophet, and I looked at the moon and the face of the Holy Prophet, but wallahi, I swear by Allah, the face of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was shining more and brighter than the moon. This is how much the Sahabas would look at the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and their following was not because they just had to follow. They understood the akhlaq of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his kamaliyah. They understand him in completeness. That is why the Sahaba ikram had so much love for the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ours is selected sunnah. Ours is selected sunnah. You read a second wife, right?
No.
That's our selected sunnah, right? It's sunnah. So, look at the hadith. Hazrat Anas bin Malik said that once I was sitting with the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he said to me, Ya Bunayya, O my son, and this is the beginning of everything of following, In qadarta an tusbiha wa tumsa wa laysa fi qalbika ghishun li ahadin fafa'al. O my son, if you are in a position that you start your morning, you spend the whole day, you go to bed at night and you sleep without harboring any ill feelings, any jealousy, any animosity over your fellow human being, please do so, my son. For inna dhalika min sunnati. For indeed, this is from my sunnah. How far are we from the sunnah? How far are we from the sunnah? فَمَنْ أَحَبَّ سُنَّتِي فَقَدْ أَحَبَّنِي. Whosoever loves my sunnah, he loves me. وَمَنْ أَحَبَّنِي كَانَ مَعِي فِي الْجَنَّةِ. And that person who follows my sunnah and he loves me, he'll be with me in Jannah. So if we have to start, let's start from here. Let us purify our hearts. Let us clean our hearts. Let us show love. Because the whole concept of deen, it's love. One person was speaking to me, our brother, from another firqa. 1 hour he was speaking about Hazrat Muawiyah and Yazid. And on Hazrat Muawiyah, I said to him, my brother, you spoke about for almost 1 hour about a sahabi who saw the Holy Prophet who was in the company. That's on hatred. If you were going to spend 1 hour on love, what do you lose? So ours and what the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has shown us is that very deen of love. If we can start by loving, then it will make the world a better place. The world is not in need of doctors, it's not in need of psychologists, it's not in need, it just needs love. Those people who follow that sunnah of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that of showing mercy and compassion to one another, then once we achieve this, inshallah, we'll be amongst those not who yearn to be at Kawthar, but to drink from that very hand that will be giving water and the pools of Kawthar. Let us conclude with salawat upon the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allahumma salli wa sallim ala Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Wallahu yaqulu al-haq wa huwa yahdi as-sabil. MashaAllah, subhanAllah, this was Mufti Salim. So you can understand where I get some of my knowledge from. You say, no. But it's.
Astaghfirullah.
When I told you,
scholars have said that whatever we do, we must always make istighfar. Even if after praying, we must make istighfar. Because the worst thing that a believer will ever do is to show ujub. When you start to think that you are better, that is the first stage. Jazakallah for the compliments, but this is a reflection of who he is. This is a reflection of who he is. He's a good man, so he sees good in me. I'm done. Talk about yourself. We had one man who came to speak about himself 1 hour. So you can speak about yourself.
Alhamdulillah, we were fortunate to have him and we have learned a lot. There are some things I didn't really know. And I've learned some good salawat and some good hadith. Alhamdulillah. Now, for the next... Where's our other MC here? In a way, he was instructed to be the MC. I don't know why I'm doing this. Can you please come sit here now? You were instructed to be the MC, and you're making me do all the work. I'm so happy that I am not able to, that I'm not speaking to them, because the next person you must call is Father. He's going to address us today.
No, I can't. I won't be able to address Mark. I haven't concluded my research yet, inshallah. There's still some research that I'm doing. But I have to take this opportunity to thank our Sheikh. I don't know where Sheikh Maulana, where he is.
He's still on his way, inshallah. He's coming with the camel.
But I would like to thank you on behalf of everyone, because we have learned a lot. And especially you guys sitting there in front, your shoulders are very heavy. Your shoulders must be broad, because you are, as much as you don't like it, you are our ulama. You are the people that guide us. And when you are in front of us, we bind ourselves with you in the salah. Because your shoulders, you have achieved that rank to carry the shoulders and our mistakes that we have. You know, and it's not an easy thing. Allah has blessed me with friends like yours, you know, that I can communicate on a daily basis. And I think on behalf of all of us, we make shukr, that we know on these nights, the angels have written our names with your name. So thank you. And this is from the bottom of all our hearts. And yeah, keep on guiding us.
So your research is not complete.
Allah Kareem.
After Alana Salim spoke, I have absolutely nothing to tell you, but I have absolutely nothing to tell you except for his last of what he said about tazkiyat an-nafs, you know, all the other sunnahs, this, that, and the other. It is important for us to take this journey of tazkiyat an-nafs. There's different stages. We have discussed this multiple times on the minbar, especially there by me, of what is tazkiyat an-nafs. We do not understand it. That's why sometimes we say we keep on talking about tazkiyat an-nafs. It's because we do not understand the levels of the nafs that there is. And for you to send salawat upon Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and to hear his reply, your heart must be clean to hear this reply. Like he said, some angels must clean, do this, do that, to make it beautiful, to present it to Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then you get people like Sheikh Abdul Qadir al-Jina, and Sheikh Ahmad Kabir Rifai, and Sheikh Ibrahim al-Dusufi, and Sheikh Sa'ad al-Din al-Jabawi, radiallahu anhum ajma'in. People who give salah and Rasulullah respond directly to them. For you to reach that level is you have to go through this tazkiyat nafs. Then you cannot do it alone. You cannot do this on your own. You need somebody to guide you. So I will leave you with this, that if you do not take that opportunity while you have it now, you should take it before you leave this dunya. Because at the end of the day, إِلَّا مَنْ أَتَى اللَّهُ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ. Nothing will help you except the one who returned to Allah with a sound heart, a clean heart, inshaAllah. And, you know, the doors of wilaya is open for everyone. I will leave it to you to continue with the program. And I say this again, if Maulana don't come at all today, and I will take off tomorrow completely. I'm joking.
Brothers, this brings us to the next part of our program, which is the praises of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And if I may, I know it is impromptu, but Maulana of Oasia Islamic Education Center, if we can call you forward, please, to start us up and get the engines going. Barakallahu fiqh.
Can I have ijazat? have bills to pay. I need to rush to work. Inshallah. Jazakumullah khair.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. تداعنا ننادي مولا جليلا إذا الليل أرخى علينا السدودا نظرت إليك بقلب دليل لأرجو به يا إلهي القبول دعونا نناجي مولا جليلا إذا الليل أرخى علينا السدولا نظرت إليك بقلب إذا الليل أرخى علينا السدولا لك الحمد والمجد والكبرياء وأنت الإله الذي لن يزولا لك الحمد والمجد والكبرياء وأنت الإله الذي لن يزولا وأنت الإله الذي لم يزل حميدا كريما نعيما جليلا دعونا ناجي مولا جليلا إذا الليل أرخى علينا السدولا دعونا ناجي مولا جليلا إذا الليل أرخى علينا السدولا تميت الأنام وتحيي العظام وتمشي الخلائق جيلا فجيلا تميت الأنام وتحيي العظام وتمشي الخلائق جيلا فجيلا عظيم الجلال كريم في عادي جزيل النوال تنيد السعود دعونا ناجي مولا جليلا
الليل أرقى علينا السود لا دعونا أناجي مولا جليلا إذا الليل أرقى علينا السود لا
خزائن جودك لا تنقضي تعم الجواد بها والأخلا خزائن جودك لا تنقضي تعم الجواد بها والباخلا دعونا نناجي مولا جليلا إذا الليل أرخى علينا السدلا دعونا نناجي مولا جليلا إذا الليل أرخى علينا السدلا دعونا نناجي مولا جليلا إذا الليل أرخى علينا السدلا
سبحان الله.
Allah, Allah, Allah. Allah, Allah.
Sheikh Zakir Yunus, you've been summoned to the front. Subhanallah.
Should I can bring a mic to you?
No, I'm coming.
Nare Tadbir, Nare Risalat,
Ya Rasulullah.
Sallallahu alayka ya Rasulullah.
Aka, 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 aka
چمك تجھ سے پاتے اے سب پانے والے میرا دل بھی چمکتے چمکانے والے مدینے کے کھیتے خدا تجھ کو رکھے غریب و فقیر کے ٹھہرانے والے برستا نہیں دیکھ کر ابر رحمت بدوں پر بھی برستے برسانے والے صلی اللہ علی محمد صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم صلی اللہ علی محمد محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم نور على نور يا رسول الله نور على نور يا حبيب الله سے چھپ جانے والے حرم کی زمین اور قدم رکھ کے چلنا ارے سر کا موقع اے اور جانے والے رہے گا یوں ہی ان کا چرچا رہے گا برے خاک ہو جائے جل جانے والے ابائی شفاعت کی ساعت بائی ذرا چھین لے میرے گھبرانے والے صلی اللہ علی محمد
صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم صلی اللہ علی محمد صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم
نور على نور یا رسول اللہ نور على نور یا حبیب اللہ
ہم بھی دیکھیں گے ہمیں بلوائیں گے آقا مدینہ ہم بھی دیکھیں گے
میرے آقا 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 اے میرے آقا 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 میں مجرم ہوں آقا مجھے ساتھ لے لو کہ رستے میں ہے جب جاتانے والے تیرا کاہے تیرے غلاموں سے الجھ میں منکر جب خانے گھرانے والے رضا نفس دشمن اے دم میں نہ آنا کہاں تم نے دیکھ اے چندرانے والے
صلی اللہ علی محمد صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم صلی اللہ علی محمد صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم نور على نور یا رسول اللہ نور على نور یا حبیب اللہ
مولا يا صل وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كلهم مولاي صل وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كل نبي حبل غير منفصل مولاي صل وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كلهم محمد سيد القومين و مولاي صل وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كلهم ثم الرضا عن أبي بكر وعن عمر وعن علي وعن عثمان سلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كلهم مولاي صل وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كل بالمصطفى بلغ مقاصدنا واغفر لنا ما مضى يا واسع الكرم مولاي صل وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كل صل وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كلهم مولاي صل وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كلهم.
Something here from that we used to read in Cape Town that I would like to read for you guys, but I'm not like him, you know, so, and it is Arabic, it's not Urdu, so Alhamdulillah, I'm saved by that. But before, Al-Qasim was one of the companions of Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, and at this last advent of Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked everyone who was there if he did any sallallahu alayhi wa sallam injustice to anyone, then now is the time to take their revenge on Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So no one of the Sahaba, not Abu Bakr, not Umar, not Uthman, not Ali, not Sa'ad, Sa'id, Ibn Umar, radiallahu anhu ajma'in, nobody stood up except for Uqasa radiallahu anhu. And he said to Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that one day you poked me with a stick and I would like to take revenge back onto you. So Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ordered them to go fetch the stick that Rasul sallam used. So Abu Bakr, he gets upset and he stands up. He said, why don't you take what you want to take on the Rasul sallam, take it on me. It's like you're taking it on the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then Umar stand up, then Uthman stand up, then Ali stand up, then Al-Hassan, Al-Hussein, radiallahu anhum ajma'in. So Rasul sallam told him, sit down. Allah know your intention. So as He's lifting up the stick. You tell Rasulullah, you know, that day when you poked me, it was, my back was bare. There was no shirt or kameez here. I want to do the same thing. So look at the justice of Rasulullah. He asked if there was anything, anyone, I did anything to anyone. So Waqasa, he wants to do this. So Rasulullah removed his shirt. And as everybody is watching this scene that he is going to poke Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, even Umar took out his sword, you know, anyone, anything, he chop off your neck. I'll tell you this story some other time. And Al-Qasar dropped the stick in the rushes to grab Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and kiss him on his back. Why? He said, whoever touches the skin of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will not burn in the fire of hell. So it's not that he wanted to take this revenge. Huh? So you must join me, inshallah. Ya Sayyidi, Ya Rasulallah, Ya Man Lahu
Allah.
Allahu Allah, 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 Allahu Allah,
لا إله إلا الله. ربي جل الله ما في قلبي غير الله نور محمد صلى الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله
لا إله إلا الله لا إله
يا رسول الله سلام عليك يا حبيب الله سلام عليك مصطفى جاني
والنوكا زلمه